Hey guys, and welcome back to the FIFA 20 Road to Glory. Did a little bit of bronze pack method, like 2 minutes. Got this guy, Chinese Super League, he sold, we start a draft. Yeah, it's a bit of a open episode, this one. It's starting straight away. This is a draft squad I built. I'm sorry I didn't show me going through it all because I've fit the rewards in today. On episode 25, we're a quarter away to 100, and I'll tell you what, this episode is a banger. Smash a like on this video before you've even watched it, because you're definitely going to want to watch towards the end, all the way through, to see the rewards I get in this video. Not even the rewards, some of the Halloween packs, because this was filmed on Halloween. I know it's come out the day after. I'll be in Foot Champs at this time. Wish me luck. Hopefully I can break the gold 2 pact, or maybe just get it again. I'm all right with being complacent in gold 2. It's a good reward. Winner's first game in the draft, 6-0. I mean, the front three we had Ronaldo, Mbappe, then I subbed Messi on, and then later in the game I'd take Ronaldo off and maybe put Salah or Neymar on, so we had a pretty good team. But in the quarterfinals, I think this is, we don't do very well. We end up 3-1 down, but then Mbappe turns on the afterburners, puts one in like that, and I mean, we were flying in this game to start off the second half with. We got level, and then Cristiano Ronaldo, he turned his controller off for a bit, I think, and maybe it ran out or something. Don't go into games with an empty controller. That's lesson learned. I'll punish you. Well, Ronaldo will. I mean, if I didn't have Ronaldo, I'd probably still miss. That's a bit embarrassing. We go 5-3 up. The floodgates have finally opened. He gets one back to make it 5-4, make it a nervy game. And then we just kill it off with that man Ronaldo, who just felt so good to use on this game, but I doubt we'll be getting him any time soon. But if his pat luck keeps going the way it is, we might be. As you've seen from the title, we get a screen card this episode. You can guess who it is. I'll tell you something, it's won more than 100k, I'll tell you that. Definitely a good pull. This guy in the semi-finals was a better player. This guy had Messi, Pele, like the other guy. And he just wrecked me. He beat me 2-1, and he was a really decent player. So I'll take pride in losing 2-1 to him. I could have been smashed on another day, and my defense wasn't even that good. So a good thing for me there, right there. And we go into his rewards, a gold pack and a 15k pack. I'm only looking to make money and stop the club. And we actually do get a board in the 15k. England right back, Kyle Trent Alexander-Arnold. Which I was hoping for Kyle Walker. I'd made profit if I got him, but we stay the same. We get 10k, so then we've lost 5k, but the stuff we filled this club with is probably worth more than 5k overall. So happy bunny from that draft. We didn't even win it, and we did well. I don't think I've ever won a draft. That just shows my luck. We're going to the Div Rival Rewards here. We got rank 1, Div 5. And I'll tell you what, we get a board in every single pack here. We get Felipe in the first one, 84 rated. SBC fodder, if there is any. Oh, I can't speak. We get Harry Maguire and everything like that. We get a decent pack, so that was a good pack to get him in. We go into the next one, another board, like I said, Spanish. You know, when it's Spanish, it's not going to be the best. It's Ilarmendi, probably the cheapest board going. But I'm not complaining. It can go into some SBCs. It's better than getting someone like really low rated. The only low rated I would take is Ferland Mendy, because he's about 40k, I think. Same with Adair Militao. Maybe his Champions League card would be good. We get another board, another Spanish one in Diego Costa. I mean, he'll get chemistry if we need chemistry in a high rated squad with Ilar Mendy, so swings are in roundabouts. We get this guy, I think it's Romagnoli. We get him about 3 hours before he turns into a screen card himself, so that was pretty annoying. But we get a walkout in the next pack. English are like, no good informs. It's Harry Kane. I mean, the most underpriced Premier League striker there is. We've used him before. We didn't enjoy him. He's definitely SBC fodder at the end of the day. Along with this guy, an inform from Netherlands. I was thinking Van Dijk, but then we didn't even get a walkout, and we actually just got a random Stengs guy. Not really bothered. Here we go into the Foot Champs Rewards. Gold 2. 2 player pick. 45k. We're going to be upping money now. I think we're over 100k now. And we get his first reward. Can we get something good? We don't. We get a Jose Perez in the end. I mean, I can see me getting Leicester players in this, because Leicester did have a 9-0 result away at Southampton to break the record in the Premier League's most wins away, which were a good result. Can we get Mbappe or Fabinho in the next pack? We don't. We get Chilwell, like I said, Leicester player. We're just getting them to. We'll be in chemistry for the 86 plus, what do you call it, the SBC with the upgrade, so I can get an 86 three-player pick when I submit a team full of them. So we've got Duffy, Theo Hernandez, Traore maybe. Maybe we'll put in from Traore and them two into that SBC that we can use later on. We get Rulison there, about an 8k player. Used to be like 20, so that's a disappointment. To say he wasn't aboard and he was worth that much at the start of FIFA, bit disappointing. We don't get anything in the next pack. We don't get anything in this one. As Foot Champs rewards were worse than as Div Rival rewards, and we grinded so hard for them Div Rival rewards, for them Foot Champs rewards. We can only hope we get the, better next year. We sell Jack Grealish, we sell Aaron Cresswell in the club, two of his informs, and we go and buy, I know, I packed him. We go and buy him again. But this SBC, I overspent, I didn't even spend, I put some players in that I probably shouldn't have, Pereira and all that, six rare gold players. We put that team in for the costume party Halloween SBC. It's a scream card. It's a walkout. It's Brazilian. It's a centre forward. It's in ultimate scream Bobby Firmino. That is, I mean, his stats look as good as Hullet's. That right there is 600k at the moment. That card is 600k. I didn't even think he were usable as a striker. He'd be an amazing central midfielder. We're going to definitely sell him. I mean, we're going to wait until the scream is over, so all the players rocket in price because you can't pack them anymore. I think that's got 3 days left. And we're going to go in for the kill. We're going to get all that money. And we're going to just absolutely build his team, stack his team up. We could get player of the month Aubameyang. I mean, I'm not good. I think he's most overpriced. I was thinking about it, and then I thought, nah, he's overpriced. We're not going to stop there, though. We're going to go into these SBCs, all of them. We're going to just try and complete as much as we can on Halloween. What a Halloween. 600k player. I got Modern Warfare as well. I went out and bought Modern Warfare with my money. If you want some videos on that, maybe suggest it. I don't know. We get an 85 rated player in Higuain from the marquee matchups, which, I mean, the amount of boards we've had today is just amazing. We got Kante before, but this is the best rewards I've ever had. I mean, I bet it goes up to 700k once they go out of packs. Maybe that's maybe a little superstitious, but hopefully he does. 700k to buy a team. Recommend some players down below for that price. I don't want to splash out all my money. I don't want to keep him. I mean, he's tradable. I don't want to keep him in my club, a 600k player, when all rest of my players are like 50 to something k. Like, I've got Kante, I've got Lacazette. None of my players are cheap now. Probably my cheapest is Davids and Sanchez at about 20k. But maybe we could upgrade to, I mean, Van Dijk is on the table right now. Still got his loan card to use, but I'm happy with Davinson Sanchez. I'm happy with my team. Maybe it takes an SBC to put my money up, get me another player. As you can see, I've stacked the club out with like Navas and Verratti and all that, and I sell Leroy Sané. I mean, no games used. I didn't even use a game with him, and he's gone. We're probably gonna have like 800k when Firmino sells after this. But the reason I did this is because I want to do the PK SBC, and I go ahead, and I don't think I've included this, I go ahead and buy Felipe Anderson back with a Hunter card for 12k, I think, just to replace him in the weekend league for this weekend league coming up. So I hope you have enjoyed this banger of an episode. It's a game changer. Comment, subscribe, like, and share. Different order that time. We go ahead and buy Cavani just to get close to that PK. I don't do him in this episode, so you're not missing out on him. He'll be in the next episode if we go ahead and get him. So maybe in the next episode, we'll have got gold one, we'll have 800k. You never know what's going to happen on this road to glory. Things are moving forward. We haven't stepped back at all. We're keeping going. I know it's not like an amazing one with loads of icons and loads of big players. I mean, we've got some big players, don't get me wrong, but I mean, I haven't got the Messis, I haven't got the Ronaldos. I'd like to have them, but I don't have them at the moment. There's the PK. I'm not going to go for Chong. I've got Walcott. I'm muttering on now. I hope you've enjoyed the episode. Goodbye. Peace.